It's finally here. GPT-4 has released today. And in this video, I want to go over everything that you might have missed from their live stream, as well as their public announcement. So make sure that you watch this video all the way through because you're not going to want to miss a thing. This release has some very interesting things in it. So the technology of GPT-4 was designed to power technologies such as chatbots, search engines, and do everything from just answering questions to programming online tutors. You can do so many things with GPT-4. GPT-4, which learns its skills by analyzing huge amounts of data culled from the internet, improves on what powered the original ChatGPT in several ways. It is more precise and can even ace the uniform bar exam. It can calculate someone's taxes and provide detailed descriptions on images. OpenAI is selling access to GPT-4 so that businesses and other software developers can build their own applications on top of it. A handful of companies, including Morgan Stanley, Wealth Management, and Khan Academy, are already working with GPT-4. But the new technology has some human shortcomings. It may require businesses to put up with imprecision, at least for now. OpenAI plans to build and deploy systems that can juggle multiple types of media, including sound, video, as well as text and images. OpenAI also did a live stream today where they showed off some of GPT-4's capabilities. And let me tell you, it was pretty dang impressive. If you didn't catch the developer live stream, here's some of the stuff that you missed. The first thing that they mentioned is that you should smash that like button. I'm just kidding, but you should still hit that like button. It greatly helps us out. The live stream started with Greg Brockman, president and co-founder of OpenAI, using GPT-4 to build a Discord bot. He also walked through the coding process and showed that you can import entire documents to give GPT-4 context on how to problem solve broken code. It was seriously impressive. After that, Greg showed us how using that same Discord bot that was just created, you could use GPT-4's image understanding to identify images and create descriptions based on those images. Another thing that was talked about in the article released by OpenAI is how GPT-4 can perform logic tasks about those images. Things like submitting an image of a bunch of balloons, having the AI identify the image, and then asking it what would happen if you were to cut off one of those balloons. And the best thing is that GPT-4 understands what would happen. Greg then went on to take a picture of a joke website that he doodled on a notepad and asked GPT-4 to turn it into a website. And it did. He then proceeded to give GPT-4 a tax problem, which it handled beautifully. The various applications for GPT-4 are endless, but we're all gonna have to wait a while to get our hands on GPT-4 as they are slowly rolling it out and there's currently a waiting list. And now the question we've all been waiting for, when will GPT-4 come to ChatGPT? Well, I've got some great news. It is already inside of ChatGPT. You can go in there and test it yourself. When you open ChatGPT, you can already see a pop-up that tells you, hey, would you like to try out GPT-4? And you can. OpenAI stated today that the image functionality where GPT-4 can understand images and export text about that image will be coming to ChatGPT in the near future. Until then, you can think about all the ways that you're going to use this new functionality inside of ChatGPT and inside of GPT-4. OpenAI releasing GPT-4 is seriously impressive. And if you're scared to use AI, you should definitely watch this video next where we go over all the reasons why you shouldn't be afraid of AI and instead embrace it and import it into your workflows. It's right there.